Welcome to the spoken tutorial on using GChem to draw a circuit schematic. After completing this tutorial, you will be able to create a circuit schematic using GChem. Generate the netlist from it for simulation using NGSpice. Another tutorial explains how to make a printed circuit board from this schematic. In this tutorial, I have used snapshot version of ZenWalk GNU Linux, which is a free operating system derived from Slackware, available at www.zenwalk.org. Instead of this, you may also use Ubuntu Linux. Jeddah Suite version 1.7.2 available at jeddahproject.org. To install Jeddah Suite, use XNET package in ZenWalk or Software Center in Ubuntu. To understand how to install packages in Ubuntu, refer to Ubuntu Spoken Tutorials. Prerequisites to understand this tutorial are circuit theory, analog and digital electronics, skills in operating GNU Linux systems, and basics of SPICE. On a ZenWalk system, right-click on the desktop to get the desktop pop-up menu. Start GChem by clicking on the link to Jeddah Schematic Editor in the Applications menu. Ubuntu users, please click on Applications menu and choose Jeddah Schematic Editor. This is the opening screen of GChem. You can close the status dialog box by clicking on the Close button. GChem belongs to Jeddah suite of programs. It is used to draw schematics and symbols. Schematics should be drawn within this area. Clicking on View displays this pull-down menu. Keyboard shortcuts or hotkeys to perform different operations are given in this menu. It is much faster to use hotkeys instead of operating the mouse. For example, type VL on the keyboard to get light color scheme for drawing area. Type Z to zoom in and Shift Z to zoom out. We can also zoom in and zoom out by turning the mouse wheel up and down. Finally, zoom extends by typing VE. This is the circuit we propose to simulate using NGSpice. In this circuit, we need to find VA and the power delivered by this current controlled voltage source. We also need to verify Kirchhoff's voltage law and Kirchhoff's current law. In NGSpice, a DC voltage source of 0 volts is used as an ammeter to measure current. We insert them in branches where current has to be measured. We also need to indicate the reference node with respect to which all other node voltages are measured. Without this, SPICE simulation does not work. To create this schematic, we require the symbols of current source, voltage source, resistor, current controlled voltage source, and ground. Clicking on Add displays this pull-down menu. There are options in this menu to place a component, a net, a bus, an attribute, text. These are used to draw the schematic. Options to draw line, box, circle, arc, pin and picture are useful while drawing symbols. When the required symbol is not available, we have to create it. Symbol creation is explained in another tutorial. To add a component to the schematic, we can click on this button or we can type the keyboard shortcut I. When we type I, this dialog box appears listing all the libraries. We can open a library by clicking on the small triangle beside it. If we do not know in which library the required device symbol is present, we can type the initial few letters of the name of the device in the filter to locate the symbol. For example, to find resistor symbol, we can type resist in the filter to list the related symbols as shown here. We can select resistor 1 sim. Its preview is shown. This symbol has reference descriptor indicated as refdes-r. In SPICE, single letters are used to specify different components. For example, R refers to resistor, V refers to a voltage source, I refers to a current source, H refers to a current controlled voltage source, and so on. Do not remove the reference descriptors as they are needed for simulation. More information about reference descriptors of devices is given in the tutorial on NGSPICE. Drag the resistor symbol and click in the drawing area to place it. Observe the refdes-r with a question mark. Right click in the drawing area to deselect the symbol. Similarly, select the DC voltage source symbol and place it in the drawing area. Observe the refdes-v with a question mark. Deselect by right-clicking in the drawing area. Select the current controlled voltage source and place it in the drawing area. Deselect by right-clicking in the drawing area. In the same way, place the current source symbol also in the drawing area. See the refdes-i with a question mark for the current source. Right click to deselect. Place the ground symbol in the same way. Observe there is no refdes for this symbol. Deselect by right clicking. We should note that there are also components in libraries which cannot be used in SPICE but which are needed for making the printed circuit board of the circuit. Now we have placed all the required symbols, so click on the close button to close the library. We can select a component in the workspace by clicking on it in the select mode. This is the select tool. We can make a copy of the component by first selecting it and then typing C and then dragging the copy. After selecting a component, if we type ER, the symbol is rotated by 90 degrees. We can make multiple copies of a selected symbol by typing EY. We can delete a component by pressing del key after selecting the component. All editing commands are listed in this Edit pull-down menu. To add value of a resistor, double-click on the resistor symbol. Under Add Attributes, select Value in the pull-down menu. Enter value of the resistor in the space provided with the required scale factor used in SPICE. Select Show Value Only in the Visibility pull-down menu and click on plus add button. Click on close. Now the value is added to the resistor. To change the value of a resistor, double click on its value. Type new value and click on OK button. Similarly, values for all other components can be entered. After making copies of components and entering values and placing them, the schematic will be like this. Type N to start AddNets mode. In this mode, we can make connections. In networking mode, a small circle appears as shown. We can cancel networking by right-clicking. After making all connections, the schematic will be like this. Clicking on Attributes gives this pull-down menu. In this menu, click on Auto Number Text. In the Auto Number Text dialog box, select Search for Refdes equal to star, Auto Number Text in Current Page, Starting Number 1, and click on Apply. This numbers the components automatically. Click on Close. Clicking on Add Text button opens this dialog box to enter text. Type verification of Kirchhoff's laws and click on Apply and drag the resulting text line beside title as shown and click to place it there. Click on Close to close the text entry box. In Select mode, double click on the wire on the left side of V3. Add A as net name. Select Show Value Only and click on Add. Move the net name to proper place. Similarly, add name B for the node on the right side of V3. This is the completed schematic. We need to save this. Type FS. Give the file name as KVL-KCL. Select appropriate directory to save and click on Save. Now the file is saved. We need to generate the SPICE netlist from this for simulation. Close GSchem Editor. Open Terminal and go to the directory where the kvlkcl.sch file is stored. Type the command. And press enter. This generates the spice netlist file kvlkcl.cir in the same directory. If your file names are different, change accordingly. The netlist file can be opened in any text editor like Genie. This file can be loaded in NGSpice to conduct simulation. More details about simulation commands are explained in the tutorial on NGSpice. This completes the tutorial. In this tutorial, we have learned how to create a circuit schematic using GSCAM and generate the netlist from it for simulation using NGSpice. Draw schematic to simulate this circuit and generate its netlist. Watch the video available at the following link. It summarizes the spoken tutorial project. If you do not have good bandwidth, you can download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops using spoken tutorials, gives certificates to those who pass an online test. For more details, contact@spoken-tutorial.org. Spoken Tutorial Project is a part of the Talk to a Teacher project. It is supported by the National Mission on Education through ICT, MHRD, Government of India. More information on the same is available at http://spoken-tutorial.org/NMEICT-intro. This is R.S. Anand Murthy from SJ College of Engineering, Mysore, signing off. Thank you for joining.